Welcome back to Forza Horizon 4. We are here at the Formula Drift Forza Friday Open Lobby. If you didn't see that, I posted on my Instagram. You can follow in the description below, at mflareman. Look at it. It's on my car right here. And we are going to be doing a Formula Drift competition. I have selected 8 of the best drivers. I don't know why we have 7. We should have 8. Of
best.
The best drivers available.
Behind McDonald's?
No. The best elite Forza drivers we could find, and we are here for a Formula Drift style competition, tandems, all that jazz. So let's get into it. Let's talk about the course. I'm gonna pull out. You guys follow me, and we're gonna take a look at the course here. God, the clutch is so spotty on this thing. So if you take a look, follow me here.
Tractor.
You are not going to enter at this sign here. You're going to enter at these signs that say 50. That's where you're going to make your big entry. Then you're going to swing down through this corner. You want to try and get as far inside here as possible. Hit a good apex here and extend it out before transitioning into the next corner here. You're going to transition. Not like that, but you're going to transition. Try and follow the inside line here. Pull all the way out and then one last big transition into the final corner right here, and you're going to finish once you straighten out here when the road becomes straight. Does that course seem pretty straightforward for you guys?
Yeah,
it's nice and simple. Yep.
So now I'm going to give you guys some practice time. You guys can feel free to go up and down the course as much as you want for the next 15 or so minutes just to get prepared for the race, or the competition, I should say, since it is not a race. And then we're going to get into pairing you guys up for the first round of the tandem competition.
Something tells me it's going to be me versus Evan.
we'll see.
If I see a SpongeBob 15 minutes later in the video, I'm going to give it.
A damn tractor.
15 minutes later.
It's a Nissan.
You mean Datsun?
I thought you're gonna do a Doug DeMuro style, be like,
This is my 1996 Nissan 240SX. It features a Rocket Bunny boss kit and lots of power. I don't know much about it. I don't care to search.
Well, my car, you might recognize this car. This is the legendary Cross Corvette designed by me.
Download it.
Number 419 today. 1,050 horsepower, 850 foot-pounds of torque, 3,000 pounds with a 6-point... Actually, that's technically a 7-liter V8.
I just now noticed that your freaking 419 on the other side is mirrored.
Yeah, it's backwards. That's how drift cars are, bruh. For those of you who don't know how Formula Drift works, it is a tandem competition where the two cars swap between lead and chase position in the tandem for a run each, and the winner is decided through score, which we can't necessarily do, but we're just going to go off the democracy of the other people in the party here and hope that I get a good result today, because it would be awkward if I didn't.
3, 2, 1, go!
I have to let the lead car go first, so I can't, like, false start or anything.
I was wondering what you're doing hanging back there. Look at that sink on those cars as they're coming around the big old curve right there. Ooh,
hold
we
on
still
a second.
Had a couple of traffic cars in the
yeah,
way.
Yeah, where are those
drifters
coming from?
Yeah, they must be spawning in the middle. I don't get why. I thought this course was short enough that we could have this covered.
I had to slow down and straighten out for them because I wasn't sure if we were going to keep the run going.
Yep. Ooh, look at the backfiring coming from Patrick's front exhaust pipes and across the line.
Do you want to run that back, Patrick?
Am I following now?
Well, either that or do you want to redo the lead run because of
I
didn't see any traffic on my screen.
I have swapping positions this time. Are you boys ready?
Yep.
All ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Ooh, this time Max is going in front of Patrick. Giving a real swap up this time. I do say I love the smell of tire smoke in the afternoon. Reminds me of bonfires.
You can't smell it.
I don't care. I put scented strawberries on my tires.
Gone.
Yeah, even though Max is faster than Patrick, the question is who will look better on film? Because right now, I won't state my opinions, but I think I might have one.
All right.
It's probably Max.
The runs are over now. Just to clear up, in Formula Drift, there are three options. You either slide to the driver that you want, being either me or Patrick. Those are two of the options. And then there is a third option being one more time where we would go in another round where we would swap positions again and do another set of tandems to, redecide the winner if there is too much of a tie or there is no majority. Back. We've decided to go one more time because we had some lack of drone footage and some blocking things that we needed to figure out. But now that we are back, we have an extra two competitors here. Nick and Javier are here.
I'm not actually there yet.
And we are going to run a one more time here. So, Patrick, are you ready?
Yes.
I am as well. Ethan, count us off.
Can do, Chief. 3, 2, 1, go! Tasty. Look at that tire smoke. Ooh. Max is getting a little bit squiggly right there for that turn. I do have to say, you guys do put on a good show. You guys are very clean, apart from a couple squiggles. I would assume that this was the actual Formula Drift team. So take that for what you will. 3, 2, 1, go! Oh, they're wiggling, and they're going straight down the line, with Patrick, of course, being in front this time because we're switching things up. Oh, getting a little touchy back there with Patrick and Max.
Dude, I didn't hit him on my screen. That was insane.
Slower, and he's ahead, which means Max is just trying to overtake him right now, but Patrick is, being a little bit feisty, but then again, it's drifting. You can't really have too much control.
Yeah, it was hard because I was chasing. I can't overtake him, so it's difficult for me to try and stay in tandem without having to grip without my car gripping back up.
So fast.
Yeah, like my car gripped up the moment, like when I got really close to him on that second big corner here. So like, what after we did the big entry and the big transition, like right about here where I'm at now. When I was tandeming with you and I got mad close after an insane transition, I was in fourth gear and I was trying to stay with you as best as I could, but you were just too slow in comparison to my car, so my car gripped up in the middle of fourth gear and I was like, crap, I'm gonna straighten out. So I had to panic and just slam the handbrake to try and keep it in drift.
All right, it's now time for us to converse. Brian, what do you think?
I saw Max streaming a lot, but I saw him like be more stable than Patrick.
So what's your opinion? Because I already have I have mine done. I just want to hear what you think.
I mean,
don't worry, this is a judgment free zone.
Yeah, because Max pulled a pretty sick transition there.
Traffic car coming through. Make the
information. All right, because Patrick on the first run seemed pretty stable, but that's because he was in the back, and then of course this time, since he was in front, Max was less stable because, you know, he's trying to overtake him.
Yeah.
But overall, even though nobody would like me to say it, I gotta vote Patrick.
Yeah, I gotta give it
really?
Patrick. Yeah.
That's
what a surprise to me.
I mean, I would just think just the proximity on my lead run away from him alone was enough to win it, but alright.
This run, we have Ethan leading and Kiwi trailing.
Oh my god, come on, you piece of crap. What are you doing?
Very straight run from both of these drivers. Kiwi getting more smoke, and he's off! He's gone off massively. Ooh, Kiwi gonna slow down? He does. What a gentleman as we head into the final corner of this run here. Ethan still taking an incredibly straight line. Kiwi with a much stronger amount of angle there. Lots of smoke from that Mustang. I don't know, Patrick. This seems like this is going to be a tough one to pull back.
True.
Dude, my game is having so many bumps in it. It's not going to end well for me.
No excuses.
Ow.
a very quick start from Patrick. He's eager to get this final run going of the first match of semifinals. Kiwi having a big opening angle there. Ethan somewhat lagging behind, starting to straighten out. Not a lot of smoke from him. Kiwi with an amazing transition. You could almost see the front left wheel lifting up there, almost like a three-wheel motion type. And a big transition into the final corner. Ethan still looking incredibly straight. He hits the grass again, cuts the corner, and flings out massively
and into
wide.
Into the field of sheep.
I don't think this Yeehaw. Is up for debate. I think Kiwi objectively wins this here.
Yes, Kiwi wins so I can leave. They're holding me hostage.
Kiwi, you have officially secured what could possibly be... Oh, yeah. Third place. Congratulations, Kiwi. You have gotten third place in the inaugural Formula Drift Open Lobby. Very impressive. Nice.
I will take fourth on that because I have to go, so...
I would take whatever place.
Three, two, one, go.
Penis.
And they're at it. Brandon is here. He's joined us suddenly. He's saying bad words, but it's okay.
It
a
is
huge
a
entry here from Mr. Patrick. Javi straightening out, but getting out to the outer zone a lot better, hitting some fencing there. Patrick really flying through this course. No chase whatsoever. They're both taking the middle line, and Javier goes in the dirt. He's off the track. Too much angle. As Patrick rounds the final corner here, a very strong lead run from Patrick. Tons of distance, tons of angle and speed. I'm sure he's happy with that as Javier crosses the finish line.
That fucking sucked.
I only drive all-wheel drive drift cars, mate.
3, 2, 1, go. Very strong starts from both of them. Wow. Javier trying to get a huge Scandinavian flick entrance here. He's starting to distance himself from Patrick very quickly as we head into the first corner. But Patrick's starting to catch up heading into the back section of the track. They're both taking the outside line here. Little bit of counter steer from both of them going into this corner, turning into the corner to try and keep the slide going. Javier really bringing it around into this last corner. He stretches out, goes far outside, lots of angle, but not as much speed. And there's a little bit of a tap, and that's the final run. We'll see. Does this go one more time, gents? Anybody have any thoughts? Drivers? Anybody? Personally, I would say it goes in Patrick's favor just because of the first run. I think Javier's second run was fantastic. I thought it went super well. But going off in the dirt on that first run was just catastrophic for his chase.
Agreed.
Patrick played that shit. No rerun.
I think Patrick gets it. So okay, Patrick moves on to the finals, which is quickly becoming Thug Finals. As I come back up to try and reclaim a spot, Ethan, unfortunately, having to leave mid-lobby here means he transferred over his final slot to another member of Team Wisconsin. Also, I have no engines now.
It's okay,
Nick, don't tell me you actually tried to drift
that. I don't care if I lose. I'm not the best
at this. My Ferrari?
No, no, the limo.
I'm not in a limo, Doc.
Oh.
Howdy, partner.
Howdy.
3, 2, 1. Go. Ah, yes. Patrick starting. Cargo broom. Yes. Both take a nice corner. Flare man is trying to drive it straight. Okay. Slidey boys. Patrick over here getting more angle.
Oh shit.
Patrice has got it.
Yes, I do have to concur. Patrice.
You know it's not 1-1. Right? You know it's not one run, right? I have to do a lead run.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay. Patrick taking the outside. Okay.
That was bad.
That felt pretty good on my end. I was a little iffy about.
Yeah, dude, it was honestly you fucking slated that round.
Forzathon live starts at 4 minutes and 55 seconds.
I'm just glad it's not right here.
When that popped up.
So yeah, everybody who watched that, make your decisions, choose your person, then you guys can talk to each other, figure out what your vote is going to be, who's going to win that. Otherwise, if it is a tie or you feel like they need to go one more time, you can do
that. I also feel like it was a tie. You slayed that run.
You know?
You go, Slay Queen.
You know, I still have to give that one to Patrick. Or not that
seriously?
One, but like the whole
really?
Thing to Patrick, yeah.
No, I'm giving
really?
It to
Max. It's like,
no joke.
I'm giving it to
Max. Like,
I'm giving it
like Max's
giving
second
it to
run was like, Max's second run was like, he fucking slayed it, don't get me wrong. But
yeah,
his
but
first
he,
run
he went off
wasn't so,
for, like,
wasn't
the
so good.
Last corner, like, Max just dominated.
Yeah, because he had so
like
much
I said,
proximity
but no,
to
like, he killed that run. That's no doubt about that. That run was all Max, but I'm just saying, like, from seeing the first run.
I think they're talking about the tandem on the first run.
Yeah, first run, you have so much proximity to Patrick. That's what, like, really caught my eye on everything.
Like, when I was watching the first run, like, it wasn't bad. It's just, like, he didn't have a lot of angle versus Patrick had a lot of angle in it.
Yeah, true, but...
So it's, like... I don't know.
I mean, I don't know. That's between you guys to make that decision. I
you know what? Ask him one more time. One more time. ONT.
One time for the one time.
Brandon
one
says
time.
One more time.
So
Ryan
one
says
more
one
time.
More time. Does Nick say one more time?
Dude, it's already majority vote. Just go for it.
One all more right. time.
So here's the deal. We can either do this one of two ways. We can either do one more time on the run where Patrick was leading because that seems to be the controversial run of the two. Or we can do both of them.
I say just do one more with Patrick leading, and if we still don't decide.
Okay. All right, I'll switch up with you,
we'll
Patrick.
Switch.
See, it just sucks because I feel like my car's a little bit more gripped up than Patrick's, so, like, sometimes to tandem with him, I have to, like, really clutch kick it. Like, I don't know if that's noticeable, but that's kind of what happened in the first run, too.
Hey, right. You guys ready?
I'm ready.
Yes.
All right, 3, 2, 1... Go.
That's a,
What happened? I didn't see it.
Patrick went over a bit.
Rip.
That's it. Like, again, this is like a hard one. Like, yeah, Patrick
again.
Did go off the road.
So give it to Max. Max wins.
Yeah, there you go.
Yep, Max wins.
Yes! Fun finals, baby! I lost the first set. I came back. We pulled it one more time. The Cross Corvette. It's legendary. Go download it on the storefront. Thank you for watching this video. Like the video if you want to see more content on Formula Drift. Comment what cars you want to see us drift on this track. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss my videos in your sub box. And be sure to follow me on my socials below on Instagram and Twitter at MFlareMan. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye!